Hello friends, so we are here to discuss on small signal operations and models, okay, for the BJT circuits or BJT transistors to be more specific. And we are doing the session 6 of the course Analog Electronics, and let's see what is the objective for the session 6. So here we will get to understand about the learning objective for session 6 would be the collector current and transconductance, the base current and input resistance, the emitter current and input resistance, you will also gain an understanding on the voltage gain. And more so, we are going to discuss on the small signal, all this with respect to the small signal operations of the BJT, and we will also develop the equivalent circuit modules that represent its operation at a given bias point. Okay. This is because the BJT draws a finite base current, and this phenomena of a finite beta manifests itself as a finite input resistance looking into the base of the BJT transistors. Okay. And so let's consider or let's conceptualize the amplifier circuit. And here we are taking a case of base emitter junction in the forward bias and in the forward bias. Condition by which is again forward biased by the DC voltage VBE, and the reverse bias of the collector base junction is established by connecting the collector to another power supply of the voltage, that is VCC, through the resistor RC, and the input signal to the amplifier is represented by a voltage source VBE that is superimposed on V capital BE. Okay, so before we go into the discussion of the DC bias point and the operation of the small signal circuit, let's introduce you to the small signal modeling. Okay, so small signal modeling is used to approximate the behavior of electronic circuits containing non-linear devices with linear equations. Okay, so a small signal model is an AC equivalent circuit in which the non-linear circuit elements are replaced by the linear element whose values are given by the first order linear approximation of their characteristic curve near the bias point. Changing the bias moves the operating point up or down on the curve, and thus changing the equivalent small signal AC resistance and gain, right? And then now let's see what is the difference between the small signal and large signal. How large a signal needs to be in magnitude before it is considered a large signal depends on the circuit and the context in which the signal is being used. A small signal is an AC signal, more technically a signal having zero average value, that is superimposed on a bias signal or superimposed on a DC constant signal. This resolution of a signal into two components allows the technique of a superposition to be used to simplify further analysis. Now let's see the small signal transistor model. Okay, so you need to observe the circuitry that is used. The first circuitry, okay, which is the conceptual circuit to illustrate the operation of the transistor, and the second circuitry here is the circuit with the signal source, okay, VBE, with the signal source VBE, eliminating for the DC bias analysis, okay, where we have replaced VBE by V capital BE, Okay, so with the signal source VB eliminated for the DC and bias analysis. Okay, so first we consider the DC bias condition by setting the signal VBE to zero, and the circuit reduces in this fashion. Okay, when I set this to zero, so I replace the circuit by this circuit. Okay. And then we can write the relationship for the DC current and voltages as, so a representation of signal operation of BJT can be obtained by eliminating the DC source. That's what I mean to say. And now the DC current and voltages can be written as IC is equal to, we know that IC is equal to IS into e power VBE by VT, and IE is equal to IC by alpha, and similarly IB is also equal to IC by beta. So, and how are we relating VCE? VCE is nothing but VCC, okay, VCC minus ICRC, right? For active mode of operation, VCE should be, for active mode of operation, VCE should be greater than VBE minus, okay, it should be greater than VBE minus 0.4 by an amount that falls, by an amount that allows the required negative signal swing at the collector. Okay, so now let's see the collector current and the transconductance. So the collector, so if the signal VBE is applied to, okay, if the signal VBE is applied, then the total instantaneous base emitter voltage VBE will be, VBE is equal to V capital BE plus V small BE. Okay, VBE plus VBE. Okay, where did we have? Okay. Sorry. Yeah, so VBE is equal to VBE plus VB. So collector current becomes IC is equal to IS into e power VBE by VT, that is equal to IS e to the power VBE plus VBE by VT. So substituting for the VBE term here. Okay, so IC is equal to IS into e power VBE by VT into e power VBE by VT. So IC is equal to capital IC into e power VBE into e power VBE by VT. Okay. Now, if VBE is less than VT, we may approximate the above equation as IC is approximately equal to IC into 1 plus VBE by VT. Okay. So this approximation, which is valid only for VBE less than approximately 10 millivolt, and this is referred to as the small signal approximation for the BJT, and it corresponds to, say for example, the small signal approximation for a BJT is valid only for the VBE, which is less than 5 millivolt or say 10 millivolt. And under this approximation, the total collector current is given by, the total current collector current will be given by IC is equal to IC plus IC by VT into VBE. So thus the collector current is composed of the DC bias current VC, IC, and the signal component IC, that is IC is equal to IC by VT into VBE. So the equation relates the signal current in the collector to the corresponding base emitter signal voltage. So it can be rewritten as IC is equal to GM into VBE, where GM is called as the transconductance. And it is given by, so we know we have already got introduced to the term transconductance in the previous sessions. So GM is equal to IC by VT, right? So if we have to graphically represent if we have to interpret the transconductance or GM, then we observe that the transconductance of BJT is directly proportional to the collector base, the collector bias current IC, and thus to we obtain a constant predictable value. Okay, we obtain a constant predictable value of GM, and we need a constant predictable IC. And also we note that the BJT has a relatively high transconductance compared to the MOSFET transistors. For instance, when IC is equal to 1 milliamp, GM is approximately equal to 40 milliamp per volt. Unlike for a MOSFET, when GM depends on the device dimension, the width and the length, W and L, right? And GM of a BJT depends only on the DC collector current at which it is biased to operate. So the graphical, if you observe the graph, GM is equal to the slope of the tangent. So if you observe this graph, you can see that GM is equal to the slope of the tangent to the IC and VBE characteristic curve at IC is equal to capital IC, okay, at the bias point Q at this point, okay. So the small signal approximation implies keeping the signal amplitude sufficiently small that operation is restricted to an almost linear segment of the IC-VBE exponential curve. So increasing the signal amplitude will result in the collector current having a component non-linearly related to the VBE. Okay. And for a small signal, that means VB less than VT, the transistor behaves as a voltage controlled current source. And the transconductance of the controlled source is GM and the output resistance is infinity. And now let's determine the base current and the input resistance at the base. Okay, so determine the resistance by VBE, we first need to evaluate the total base current IB. Okay, so IB is equal to, we know that IB is related to IC as IC by beta. Okay, so I that is equal to I capital IC by beta, or that is plus 1 by beta times IC by VT into VBE. Right, where IB is equal to IC by beta and the signal component IB, which is given by this term, 1 by beta times IC by VT into VBE. Okay, so where therefore your base current, so substituting for IC by VT by GM gives IB is equal to GM by beta into VBE. The small signal input resistance between the base and the emitter looking into the base is denoted by R pi, and it is defined as R pi is equivalent to VBE divided by IB. So substituting for IB, okay, that is, or replacing for IB as IC by beta, you can express R pi as R pi is equal to VT divided by IB. Here we recall that because of the base current of the BJT is zero at DC and low frequency, the input resistance at the gate at the input resistance is infinite, and thus there is no and similarly, when we compare it for the MOSFET, the gate current of the MOSFET is zero at DC and low frequencies, and the input resistance, the gate is infinite, and the MOSFET, there is no counterpart to R pi. Okay. And so R pi is directly dependent on beta, and it is inversely proportional to the bias current IC. So substituting for GM and replacing, we get R pi is equal to VT by IB. Okay. And then let's see the emitter current and input resistance at the emitter. So the total emitter current IE can be determined in the form IE is equal to IC by alpha, that is equal to IC by alpha plus IC by alpha. Okay, but because IE is equal to IE plus IE, where IE is equal to IC by alpha, and the signal current IE is given by IE is equal to IC by alpha, that is equal to IC by alpha into VT VBE, that is equal to IE divided by VT into VBE. Right? So, if we denote the small signal resistance between the base and the emitter, looking into the emitter, it can be defined as RE is equal to VBE by IE. The emitter resistance is given by RE is equal to VT by IE, or RE is equal to alpha by GM, which is approximately equal to 1 by GM. So the relationship between R pi and RE can be found by combining the respective definitions. That is, you can have. Okay. That is, VBE is equal to IB into R pi. That is equal to IE into RE. Right. So R pi is equal to IE by IB. IE by IB into RE. Okay. So, which is R pi is equal to 1 plus beta times RE. Right. So, when you compare with the MOSFET, would be more useful, say, for MOSFET alpha is equal to 1 and the resistance looking into the sources simply 1 by GM. Okay, and now let's see the voltage gain. The transistor senses the base emitter signal VB and causes a proportional current GM into VBE to flow into the collector lead at a ideally infinite impedance level. So in this way, the transistor is acting as a voltage controlled current source. So to obtain an output voltage signal, we may force this current to flow through the resistor. So the total current collector voltage VCE will be VCE is equal to VCC minus ICRC, right? So when it is superimposed on the collector bias voltage, we can have the signal voltage VCE given by VCE is equal to VCC minus IC plus IC into RC, okay? And then so VCE can be rewritten as VCC minus IC into RC minus ICRC. So VCE is equal to capital VC minus ICRC. So here the quantity VCE, okay, this component is the DC bias voltage at the collector, and the signal voltage is given by VCE is equal to minus ICRC, which is equal to minus GMVB, substituting here for IC, minus GMVB into RC, or VCE is equal to minus GM into RC into VBE. Okay, which is identical to the expression that we derived earlier. Okay, and we note that the gain is identical in the form, when we compare the expressions for the BJT or for the MOSFET, they are identical in form. Okay. And so if we separating the signal and the DC quantities, and if we analyze what about the emitter current, the base current, the collector current, and the voltage gain of the amplifier is minus GMRC. And here again, we note that GM is directly proportional to the collector bias current, and the gain will be as stable as the collector bias current is made. Okay, and substituting for GM, you get AV is equal to ICRC by VT. Okay, so the DC component are determined from the DC circuit, and on the other hand, a representation of the signal operation of BJT can be obtained by eliminating the DC source and observing that the voltage of an ideal DC supply does not change the signal voltage across it will be zero, for the reason that we replace VCC by and VBE with short circuit. and the circuit contained in an ideal DC current source, these would be replaced by an open circuit. And it is useful so far as it shows the various signal current and voltages, and it is not an actual amplifier circuit, since the DC bias circuit is not shown. Okay, and the resulting circuit is equivalent to the transistor as far as the small signal operation is concerned, and thus it can be considered as an equivalent small signal circuit model, right? So now let's do one problem. This is with reference to the BJT biasing. Okay, so a volt, 20 volt signal is applied to the base of a properly biased BJT with an emitter resistance of 10 ohm, and collector resistance of RC is equal to 1K. So determine the signal voltage at the collector. Okay, so the gain is given by AC, AV is equal to RC by RE. Okay, so we know what is RC, we know what is the emitter resistance. So it is 1 kilo ohm by 10 ohm, which is equal to 100. Right? So, and VC is equal to V out, that is equal to AV V in, which is equal to AV is 100 and V in is 20 millivolt it had to be. Okay. So it is 10 into 20 millivolt. That is equal to 2 volts. And then determine. Then determine the value of RC and voltage gain in an NPN transistor amplifier with beta is equal to 250, emitter resistance of 10 ohm, and VBB is 2.5 volt, VCC is 9 volt, VCE is 4 volt, and RV is 100 kilo ohm. So IB is equal to VB. We know that base current is represented, or the equation for the base current can be written as VBB minus VBE divided by RB. Okay, so VBB is given 2.5 volts, VBE is 0.7 volts, and RB is also given, which is 100 kilo. Okay, so substituting the values, you get IB to be 18 microamps, and IC is related. IC is nothing but beta times IS. Okay, so it is 250 into, this has to be IC equal beta times IB. This has to be IB. So IB is 18 microamps. The previous also, this should be 20 millivolt. Yeah. Okay. So this is so IB. Yeah. So IC is equal to beta times IB. That is equal to 250 into 18 microamps. That is equal to 4.5 milliamp. And similarly, RC is equal to VCC minus VCE divided by IC. Okay. So IC is 4 milliamps. VCC is given, and VCE is also given, which is 9 minus 4. So it is RC will be 1.1 kilo ohm. And then AV is equal to RC by RE, which is 1.1 kilo ohm by 10 ohm, which is equal to 110. Okay, so the gain is 110. So with this, we stop, we complete the session 6, and let's continue our discussion on small signal model in the next class. See you all. Thank you.